Welcome to the Yamaha booth here at SMT Connect. I'm delighted to be joined by Daisuke Yamahashi. You're the general sales manager for Europe.
Yeah.
Okay. So nice to see you again, Daisuke. Let's take a look. We've got a full line behind us, starting off with, of course, your printer, which you're known for, the YS10. Tell us...
YSP10, right?
The YSP10.
10, yes.
Great. So tell us some of the key features of the YSP10.
Actually, YSP10 has a lot of automation functionality, such as auto-stencil change functionality, and also auto-solder paste transfer, and also auto-solder paste supply unit.
So you can get robots to actually supply the solder paste to the printer.
Yeah.
Okay. And I believe you've also got an automatic stencil changeover system.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay.
Yeah.
Is that a single stencil changeover? Like it changes one stencil, or does it change?
Actually, we can set the two stencils in total in the machine, so we can exchange the stencil.
Okay.
So, for next program.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Okay, excellent. So, I'm assuming that your YSP10 is communicating with your SPI system, which is the YSi-SP.
Yes.
Yeah. Tell us some of the features that you've built into that.
Yeah. So, SPI, detect energy part, right? Energy part, right?
Energy
for example.
Path. Okay.
Energy not so no good point, like okay. SPI so detect so the PC solder paste. Then so SPI so
basically looking at the solder paste and measuring the volume.
Okay. Yeah. So SPI knows the volume of the solder paste.
Yeah.
Our printer know the best timing of cleaning, for example.
Right.
With best timing, our printer can clean the stencil, for example.
Right. So basically the SPI will send a notice back to the printer to start the cleaning program.
Yeah. We have a feedback positioning functionality. SPI knows which position the solder paste is.
Right.
That information goes to our printer. Then printer itself change the position of the solder paste printed. I mean, printing position will be
What you mean to cover misprints and missing paste and this type of thing?
Sometimes position solder paste position.
Okay.
You understand?
Yeah. Yes.
So stencil and PCB correct the match the correct position.
Okay.
Automatically. Yeah.
Right. Okay, I understand. Okay, so then we move on to, of course, the mounters, the pick and place machines, which is what you're very well known for.
Yeah.
We have a very impressive YRM20 behind us. Tell us about the configuration inside this machine. It's a double gantry.
Yeah.
And it's got three heads in it. Three
types of head we can prepare. Yeah.
So can you tell us tell us more about the different types of heads?
Yeah. So we have three types of head unit. One is high speed head. Second is flexible head. Number three is head unit for odd shape, big components.
Right, for large components.
Yeah.
Okay. So what will that take? Maybe up to 1 inch or 30 millimeters?
Yeah.
What size
actually, the head unit for odd shape, big components can handle in maximum 30 mm height components.
30 millimeter height. Yeah. Okay. And what about on the revolver on the turret head? Does that have? Does that got 10 nozzles or how many nozzles are on the turret head?
Okay, so 15 nozzles. 15 nozzles. 15 nozzles on the high speed head.
On the high speed. Yeah. Okay, and that gives you an overall components per hour rate of how many?
Yeah, 115,000 CPH.
Wow.
Yeah.
115 CPH.
Yeah.
It's very fast.
Yeah, very fast. Yeah.
Feeder capacity here. I see that you can take up to 64.
Yeah.
These 8 millimeter feeders.
Yeah, 8 millimeter feeders. Front side, 64.
Yeah.
Feeders. rear side, 64 feeders.
Same on
in
the
total,
other side.
128 feeders.
Right,
8
right.
mm feeders, okay. Yeah.
But then if you've got any sort of advanced packaging devices or things like this to add to the board, you can then use, for example, the tray feeder that we've got here to mount the odd-shaped or the components out of the waffle trays.
Yeah.
Yeah. So this machine here is set up with for odd form and also for advanced packaging devices.
Yes. So basically, so component with tray can be handled with this, you know, tray component, tray supply unit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Good. Good. So I think that's about it. That pretty much. Then at the very end, what do we have here? What's the machine at the very end?
It's AOI, 3D AOI.
Okay.
So we developed and released last year.
Right,
yeah.
Right.
The name is YRIV. So we prepare two types of YRIV.
Okay.
One is 4 projector type. The other is 8 projector type.
Okay.
Yeah.
So where would you use these? Would you use the 8 projector post reflow?
Yeah.
After reflow?
Basically, post reflow.
Post reflow.
But we, of course, we can use before the reflow.
Before reflow as well,
yeah.
Okay. Great. So there you have it. You've got a full line. What have you got that controls the line? What software package do you have that controls all of these machines working together? Yes.
Yeah. We have that kind of software.
And all the data comes into one software.
Yeah, we have that kind of software. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. Good. So I take it business is still very strong for Yamaha at the moment, globally?
Yeah, globally, yes.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
Good. 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 Excellent. Yeah. Okay. Yeah. Well, I want to thank you for showing us the line today. And we look forward to seeing some of the new developments coming in the future. And thank you for joining us today, Daisuke.
Thank you so much.
Thank you.
At Kaizen, we know it's the science that makes the difference. The right solutions happen when you care enough to ask the right questions. And we understand that your performance is directly related to ours. Science knows why it works, care knows why it's important.